second one. I'll go to the third next. No, this won't keep going. You have to stop up every track. She's doing track by track. So I have to open the next track. That's what she thought. She didn't have it on the playlist.
Following years of struggles, in 1963 came the protests in Birmingham, Alabama. Peaceful marchers were brutally attacked.
Go to the next one.
Which is third?
Yeah.
Washington March?
Washington March.
The Birmingham March brought a national outcry against segregation and led to the awe-inspiring, momentous march to Washington for civil rights. With over 200,000 people of all races and faiths.
Well, they just have a quick change of clothes. I mean, not full change. We went through Dr. King's struggles, and after this, we just mentioned that after the march in Washington, the African Americans won a victory with the passing of the Civil Rights Bill in Congress in 1964. And soon after, Dr. King was awarded the Nobel Prize, Peace in Peace, and his struggles against inequality continued. But he fell to an assassin's bullet on April 4th, 1968. We then now come to a current event, which you will probably be very familiar with. So this current event will be portrayed now. It's the track four, right?
Four says KKK.
Yeah, KKK.
Dr. King said, people fail to get along because they fear each other. They fear each other because they don't know each other. They don't know each other because they have not communicated with each other. Is that the reason why the KKK has reared its ugly head again?
So we conclude with a benediction by an esteemed guru in India who echoes Dr. King's sentiments of nonviolence and friendship and peace. This benediction says, only friendship can conquer the hearts of all. Renounce war, forsake competition, that peace and prosperity can prevail upon the people of this world.
Dr. King said, returning violence for violence only multiplies violence, adding deeper darkness to a night devoid of stars. Mm-hmm.